side. I think you gotta go down there.
I'm not comfortable standing here.
Can we stay somewhere?
Huh? I don't want to share my mic.
Good morning, church. Our scripture, our invocation will be given by Miss Claire Martin.
This is Ephesians 6:13 through 17. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt around with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God.
Amen. Shall we pray? Dear kind Heavenly Father, we thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for a beautiful Sabbath day. We thank you for all the lovely children, Lord, that are here this morning with us. There's something special that's been planned for them. The children's ministry department, working through you, have provided what we all need today, a blessing. And so, Lord, we ask that you would be with us in this service. Be with those who wish they could be here, but for whatever reason they can't. Be with those who are on the internet listening to the service, Lord, that the blessing is not just held here in this building, but it exceeds outward, that all who come in contact with us, with our children, will know that we have been in your presence today. In Christ's name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Church, good morning, happy Sabbath. So good to be here with our children. Our opening song is "The Banner Over Us Is Love." We all know it, it'll be on the screen. Let's sing it along with the children.
Jesus is the pain, the power, and the cross. His banner over us is love. Jesus is the peace, the power, and the cross. His banner over us is love. Jesus is the peace.
banner over us is love.
Happy Sabbath. Hi, my name is Chase Martin.
And my name is Jeffrey Romaine.
We would like to take this time to welcome everyone in City Temple Church.
Will all our visitors please stand?
It is wonderful to see our church family and all of our special visitors here this morning. Thank you for coming today. Welcome one and all.
We trust that the message today will uplift and encourage you. May your burdens be lifted and may you feel comfort. God bless you and keep you. Happy Sabbath.
I'm glad you came to church today. I'm glad you came to church today. I'm glad you came to church today on this Sabbath morning. Glad you came to church today. I'm glad you came to church today. I'm glad you came to church today on this Sabbath morning. Church today. I'm glad you came to church today. glad you came to church today on this bright Sabbath morning.
Good morning. Happy Sabbath. I am Sharon Lynn Harrison. I'm a former minister of music here at City Temple. And on behalf of Lindsay Bryant, our current minister of music, I'm going to ask the music committee to join me up here as we make a brief presentation to Mr. Willie Earl Scott. So he's going to have to come off that organ for a minute. Come here. Would you come here, please? Amen. Well, this is Willie's last official day at City Temple, and we want to take, is it? That's our understanding. And we want to take this opportunity to thank you for the many, many years of service to the music ministry. I myself have been a member of City Temple since 1987. And when I came here, you were at the organ or piano then, and you have been at some instrument ever since. What I like about Willie is what I have always been impressed with, is his willingness to serve. If you're singing for a service, call Willie. Yay. If he is available, he is willing, and he will come. If you've lost a loved one and you need music accompaniment at the service, just call Willie. If he is available, he is willing, and he will come. If you need help teaching your choir a song, if he is available, he is willing, and he will come. For over 30 years at least, you have been willing, and you have come to support the music ministry of this church without complaint, without difficulty, always with cooperation, kindness, and love. Truly, Willie, in your character, we have seen Christ. Willie, will come. I see a pattern here that your parents must have placed in you at an early age. Willing will come. Over the years, you've served in various capacities of the music ministry here at City Temple, including pianist, organist, choir director, minister of music, and supported the cherubs, the chancel/church choir, youth and mass choirs, and sang for over 30 years in the bass section of God's Echoes. You also served as a musician for various churches in the metropolitan Detroit area and received many awards, including Man of the Year and the Spirit of Detroit Award. Willie, we know that as hard as you've worked, you have also had a good woman in your corner. And we don't know if she's here today, but we have a special presentation for her. And we just want to tell her thank you for the many, many years that she has shared you with us. Willie, there are so many ways that we can show you our love and support. And we've just got this brief presentation. And congregation, we're going to be giving you a date soon. The music committee will be giving you a date soon when we want to do a much greater appreciation for Willie. But on today, we want to say on behalf of the City Temple Church, I want to present you with these flowers and this token of love. And Okay, and we've been asked to have his sister, Ella, to come up and get the flowers for her sister-in-law. Oh, and Pastor, I've asked that you come and join us as well. We want to present this token of love and appreciation and know that our prayers are with you as you make your mark in Colorado. And you know, I'm a songwriter. I'm going to extend this song, but this is just a little blurb of it. Although we're sad to see you go so far away to Colorado, we know that time brings about change. And though this moment seems quite strange, we pray God's blessings over you. And know musically, you're not through. Willie Earl, we're gonna miss you. Willie Earl, we're gonna miss you. Willie Earl, we're gonna miss you. And may God continue to bless you.
Thank you so much, Sherilyn. That was beautiful. So on behalf of the music here at City Temple, the current committee, and just all of us who have known and loved Willie over the years, I haven't been to a funeral in this church where Willie hasn't been at the organ to play. And we don't even have to ask him. He's just always here. And so, Willie, we just love you and appreciate you so much. Fouchette is not here this morning, and we got some roses for her. So make sure she gets these. I hope you didn't drive your convertible today, right? Okay. All right. So we're going to give these to your sister to give to your wife. And we also have a check for you. I'm not going to tell you how much it's for, but but it's just a small, thank you, Nisi. It's just a small token from our church, from City Temple Church, to say how much we've appreciated your service through the years. Thank you so much. Okay, Pastor, your turn.
Church to church, there are always institutions, individuals who distinguish themselves as being almost, if I may say so, irreplaceable. And from the outset of the launch of ministry here in December of last year, you have been steadfast. I multiply that through the years. And I can only begin to capture the sentiment that has been expressed here today. I'm also grateful that Blake has been articulated so effectively by Brother Bertram. And that is, we have had numerous funerals here that are a service provided to our community, individuals who are not members of the church, but you're always here. That's the kind of thing that money cannot buy. That's integrity. That's dedication. That's commitment. Those are principles, a high work ethic. And to think that through the years you have carried this passion as well as selfless sacrifice, and today cannot begin to capture your value. Now, we understand that ultimately Christ is most important. And whatever we are because of him. But when we use our hands, our eyes, our ears, our minds for his glory, then ultimately we represent him. So I want to thank the Lord for you and I getting a chance to know each other. And for spending quality time and for being able to leave me with a sense of the legacy of this church because of who you are. And may God continue to bless you in Colorado. Amen. Let's put our hands together.
Just before Willie comes up, I just want to remind you, there's going to be, okay, so Willie's going to be moving away to Colorado, but he's agreed to come back so that we can give him a proper musical farewell. And so you'll be getting a card or seeing some communication that says save the date. I think it's going to be the second weekend. We're not sure, so let me not put the cart in front of the horse. So just keep that in mind. You'll get a chance to come and say words for Willie, and we'll have some, you know, wonderful music here and the community choirs that he's worked with on Sundays. We'll be here, and so we just want you to be appraised of that, and just keep that on your heart. Okay, Willie, if you have a few words.
First of all, I want to give glory to God for allowing me to be of service to you. I'm almost speechless because you all mean so much to me. I came here when I was 3. I nearly froze to death, but since that time, you've nurtured me. I bored you. The deacons used to push me off the piano and say, stop making all that noise. But I've grown. I had some handicaps when I came, and I used them for stepping stones. I've really been through a lot in my life. I didn't understand why I could drive poles, steel poles down on electrical cables and in the ground when I was in Oklahoma and still come out alive. I didn't understand that. I didn't understand why my 44 ran over my shoulder and I had to get up and run and catch it after I was putting the transmission in. I didn't understand why God was looking after me. But I said, because she's because he spared my life so many times that I was serving. And now I know why I got 2 hands and 2 feet. And I can praise him. That's because I need 2 hands and 2 feet to carry my daughter. I need that, and he let me do it. This children's church. Thank you.
pray, I bend my knee, then I talk to Jesus. When it's time to pray, I hold my hands,
Happy Sabbath, church family. We'll invite all of our little ones. Please come down. All of our children, please come down. All of them. All the little ones. This all our little ones? Amen. What a beautiful sight this is. Just before we pray, let us remember a few of our members who are in dire need of our prayer. Let's remember Elder Nolan, Miliana Bracken, to understand that she's in the hospital. And so many of our sick and shed in and dire need of our prayers. And also, brothers and sisters, let's pray for all of our children here. That the Holy Spirit will continue to dwell with them and be with them as well. I have my granddaughters up here with me, and they're going to start our prayer off. We have Brielle and Brianna, and they're going to pray, okay? I know all our little ones say, I want to pray. So we're going to have Brielle to start off, then Brianna. And now, let us, could we all get on our knees and pray? Yes, let's get on our knees. That look good. Let's bow down and kneel. Amen.
I'm not sitting down. Dear Jesus, help us for this day. Help all us over here. Help us to be obedient to our parents. Amen.
Amen.
Dear Jesus, thank you for this day. Watch over the sick and shut-ins. And help us to be obedient to our parents. Help us to do it at school. Amen.
Amen. O Lord God, our Father. Words cannot express our gratitude for your goodness and for your love. We thank thee, our Father, for this blessed Sabbath. We thank thee for those who worked so hard to put this program together. But most important, we thank thee for our little friends here, that you continue to be with them and bless them. We pray the prayer of faith that you remember all of our sick and shed-in families. Remember those oh God, who are mourning the loss of loved one, but you comfort them as well. But most important, oh God, we pray for strength, we pray for love, we pray for unity here at City Temple. But then, oh God, we ask that Thou would remove the thing that's in our heart that shouldn't be, and forgive us from our many, many sins. These are terrible times which we're living in, so help us, oh God, to be faithful. Continue to bless this program, bless the speaker of the hour, and when you do come in the clouds of glory, may we all be found faithful to spend eternity with Thee. This is our humble prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Quietly, brothers and my little friends, go back to your seats very quietly.
Good morning. Good morning and happy Sabbath.
Good morning.
Before I continue, if we have any other children that are in the audience, the Women's Ministries team is asking that you would all come down front because we want you to get the full benefit of the presentation for today. So would you please, if there are any other children, I see a few in the back, if you could come down front so that you could be with the others. And there's a few seats over here on the side if there are none there in the middle. Thank you. This is the time that we have for our announcements. And first of all, I would just like to remind the church family that we will be in a business session on tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. At 11 o'clock. And that your presence is definitely expected. And it would be appreciated because we have several things that we'd like to discuss as a church family. And your decision, your votes, your presence, and your ideas are all expected and appreciated so that the church can move forward. Also, on next Sabbath, we have the kickoff of our CFL and Youth Federation. The Friday evening service was going to be over to Burns Avenue, and then the Sabbath morning service will be here at City Temple. So we ask that you would tell all of our young people, young adults, young and old alike, you're all welcome to come and enjoy and be blessed by a service that is being planned for you. Before I turn the mic over to the pastor, there's a special young lady in my life that was once a child, too. And her name is Margaret Jones. And just briefly, on next 2 weeks from Friday, on November 4th, she will be turning 90 years old. Sister Margaret Jones. And my family and I will be traveling to Atlanta for a celebration for her. But all I'm asking is that you as a church family, as many as possible, if the pastor would hold up this card, we'll have it in the back. And Sister Celeste Lewis was so kind to use her creativity and the artwork to make up this card for us. And it says, "Happy birthday, Margaret. Happy 90th birthday, Margaret." I've got a picture up there, and several of you have already signed it, but we're asking that for those of you that did not see it, because some are already in the sanctuary, if you would please take the time to give her a a birthday wish, and she does not know that I am doing this, so I know she would be very, very pleasantly surprised and happy that you would take the time to give a birthday wish shout out to her. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Elder King. Happy Sabbath, everyone. It's a blessing to be here today, and we are especially proud of these children, and we're grateful that our children's ministries director, Erica Rudolph, has done this fabulous job. We recognize her. Let's say thank you in a tangible way to Erica Rudolph and her work, all right? Normally, we acknowledge people at the end of an event, but it's appropriate to do that now. And while I'm standing here, I wanted to be sure and do that. It was an honor to begin working on this, as it should be with all ministries, early in the year. And we sat down in my office and we communicated numerous ways by text and email and phone call. And we actually laid out a strategy for the year. And it's just a blessing that she has pulled this together through prayer and planning. And so we are grateful that all the children are here. There are a couple of items that I do want to share with you that come from the pastor's desk. So please bear with me for just a moment. We want to, before recognizing our guest today, we want to remind you that Peterson Warren is important and that there are some things that we want to acknowledge today. And since I'm not working on a podium, I'm working off at this corner, so bear with me. First of all, we acknowledge the labor of the Bone family. The Bone family, Columbus Bone and his wife Joyce. Columbus, where are you? Are you here with us today? I'm looking for Sister Bone. Where is Sister Bone? Is she here? Okay. All right. I wanted to recognize the two of them because, let me tell you what they've been involved in. They have been, specifically Columbus, has been involved in facilitating daily lunch program for our children. Amen. Now, let me tell you why that's special. It's special because they had raised enough funds where it wasn't costing our children any money. Amen. So they're asking us to assist them in continuing this process. They have run low on funds, but they have made the necessary repairs to the kitchen facilities there at Peterson Warren Academy. We're asking that you would remember Peterson Warren Academy in your giving. Please do that today. You can mark your envelope accordingly. You can just say PWA lunch program. They need a minimum donation of $10. While you are remembering that aspect, please also remember that the school bus is down and we need to repair it. It's going to cost a couple of $1,000s to get it operational again. And City Temple leadership has been gracious and allowing PWA to utilize the church bus. And they've been using that for about a week, a little bit better. And we are encouraging you to remember PWA, with the lunch program and also the school bus repairs. Now, two more things that I want to bring to your attention. A couple of weeks ago, we had a church family meeting, and it was decided by almost unanimous vote that the records or the minutes of the business meeting or family meeting would be made available to you the Sabbath prior to the next family meeting. We heard you. We appreciate your recommendations in that regard, and they are now available for you. So at the end of service, this is what it will look like, and it's on the corner of Franklin's desk. If you want to go there and take a copy, and please, one copy per family. We've made copies enough, one per family, and you can receive minutes from the last family meeting so you can know what is transpiring. Okay? I've covered those. Now, I'd like to invite Vernice to come up. And all those who were working with the leadership team of Vacation Bible School this year. Okay? So that would be Zelda, Aretha. I think I see Aretha. Okay? Franklin. Okay. Who else should we call up?
I think that's it.
Is that it? Okay. Okay. All right. All right. Come on and stand here for just a moment. Remember a couple of weeks ago, in fact, over a month ago, I mentioned to you that because of the work that was done with Vacation Bible School, and I think it's appropriate that we would recognize them today because it's children's ministry emphasis, and Vacation Bible School is another arm of children's outreach, children's ministry. But as a result of their work, I was able to write two grants, one to the North American Division. One grant went to the Sabbath School Ministries area, and because of the relationship there and the work that was done here, we found a favorable response. Another grant was written to the Ministerial Department for Transformational Evangelism. We have not heard a decision from them as of yet, but when I received a phone call, Franklin called me and said, we just received an envelope, a priority envelope from the General Conference, okay? In that envelope, Franklin, that you communicated with me about was a check for $5,000. Okay? Amen? And so that $5,000 is for the 2017 Vacation Bible School year, okay? All right? Amen. And so we're excited about this. We'll turn this into the treasurer's made payable, of course, to the church. But I wanted to acknowledge the work that you've done so that we could give an appropriate acknowledgement publicly and say because of what you've done, it gave us the impetus to be able to write that grant. And we're grateful that the North American Division saw value in that. So let's all just say amen. Amen. Thank you so much. You may be seated. All right. Finally, we'd like to recognize our guest today, and there's some guests who are here with us that are very special to me. I've known them for a number of years, and they are here in conjunction with Operation Reach Back's board leadership, and that's Pastor and Mrs. Dennis Ross. I want to invite you to stand, right? Let's give them a hearty amen. Elder Mrs. Ross, we're so grateful that you're here at City Temple today. Elder Ross is the immediate past ministerial and evangelism coordinator director for the Southern Union Conference. That's my home union conference. And so Elder Ross and his wife retired just a couple, 3 years ago and have retired to the area of the greater Orlando city, Apopka specifically. And we have just a great admiration for Elder Ross and the ministerial and outreach and evangelism tracks that they laid across the Southern Union. And churches were started as a result of their ministry. He would do the preaching. She would do the singing. Amen. And God would bless, and literally thousands of souls were brought to the Lord. We also want to recognize, here is a name that I don't want to mispronounce, Sandra Nita, okay, from Corbett, Oregon. God bless you, Sandra Nita. Let's all welcome her. And then we also want to recognize anyone else that's here with Operation Reachback's leadership team, if you would just simply stand so we can recognize you. Amen? Thank you. They've been meeting this weekend. And due to our time, and of course, we want to press on with the children's ministry program, we don't want to do the usual thing of moving around and greeting, but I'm going to ask if we could just for a moment, Willie, if we could you already did that? Okay. Okay. Well, you can say I'm not connected today. Go ahead. Correct. Good. I didn't notice Kim with the dark shades there. There she is. Kim, let's give a hearty amen for Kim's presence in the house today. Dr. Kim. Oh, I'm coming. And Sister Erin, back from Georgia Cumberland Academy. Come on, Sister Erin, stand up, sweetheart. All right? Amen. God bless you. That's right. We're so proud of you and the great A's that you're making down there. We just want to praise the Lord. And Dr. Kim, our thoughts are with you. We love you. We're praying for you in your journey. I want to thank you for bringing this to my attention. Before taking my seat, there's a person who is very special to our church, a couple actually. They're not members, but I've been visiting them like they are. Sister Sadler has been ill for quite a number of weeks. We're grateful that she's here today. Do you feel comfortable standing? All right, why don't you stand? Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. We're grateful. The Lord has blessed her. And Brother Sadler, we want you to stand as a man of God. I want you to know this is a man of God. He has stood by his wife. Amen. Amen. And mother, I want you to stand. Come on, no, stand, sweetheart. All right. Amen. Thank you so much. All right. We just want to praise the Lord for your being here today. The Lord raising you up off of your sick bed. And it's just a marvelous testimony. Am I right? It's a marvelous testimony. Amen. Did I miss anything? Okay.
I would also like to acknowledge my daughter-in-law, Fahimi, and my precious grandbabies. If you would stand right now, all the way from Ruther Glen, Virginia. Amen. Thank you.
All right. God bless you. Thank you as we continue to worship the Lord in the beauty of his holiness.
At this time, we will be collecting our tithes and our offering, and I'm going to invite Jamal Rudolph. He is going to assist me at this time.
Okay. Here is my offering.
Thank you. Officers are coming forth. Malachi chapter 3, verses 7 through 9 tell us that even from the days of your fathers, ye are gone away from mine ordinances and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, saith the Lord of hosts. But ye said, wherein shall we return? Will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. But ye say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Let us bow our heads, please. Almighty God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity and time to give. We pray that you would bless those who have to give and those who have not. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Here's my offering for Jesus, for Jesus. For Jesus, here is my offering for Jesus. I give my offering to him. Here is my offering for Jesus. give my offering to
Bring the whole tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. Test me in this, says the Lord Almighty, and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that there will not be enough room for it. Amen. Can you please stand as I read the scripture? I'll be reading Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. I can do everything through him who gives me strength. May the Lord add a rich blessing to the hearing and reading of his holy word. You may be seated.
First of all, I would like to say happy Sabbath to everyone. And I am truly honored and blessed to be here. I owe my church family a thank you. 12 weeks ago, I tore my Achilles tendon. I went from a wheelchair all the way to the point where I can walk up here. This could not have been possible without the love and the support of my church family. I appreciate the cause. And I really appreciate the prayers. I appreciate my nephew and my son who willed me to work every day to make sure that I could work. And I appreciate the pastor who sat with my mom and them during my surgery. I really and truly appreciate that. And I appreciate the constant phone calls and shares of appreciation from Dr. Martin as well. Now I have the privilege and the honor of doing the bio for our speaker today. Here's a little something about Roberta. Since most of you know her, here's just a little something that you may not know. Roberta was born in Ypsilanti. She's lived there all of her life. She even went to school in Ypsilanti. She goes to church in Ypsilanti. She even shops in Ypsilanti. And she loves to drive in Ypsilanti.
Yeah.
The last time she was here, she had 5 children, 15 grandchildren, and 16 great-grandchildren. God has blessed her with an additional one, so now she has a total of 17 great-grandchildren. Her prayer has always been that she will outlive all of them. She stands by this rule: I don't sit, knit, or babysit. Roberta loves the Lord with all of her heart, and she loves reading the Bible and Spirit of Prophecy. She has read the Bible 7 times, and she's currently working on her 8th time. She's not bragging. She's just excited about reading God's Word. She's finally published her first book entitled, Jesus Loves to Hear Me Pray. It talks about how Jesus feels when children pray to him. She's an elder and Bible worker of the Ypsilanti Church. She's the director of a weekly children's program entitled Jesus Loves Me a Champion Academy. She loves teaching all ages, but her passion is teaching children. She has recently retired from the University of Michigan in 2014, but God has called her back, and he called her back to Peterson Warren Academy, where she had previously worked from 1985 through 2000, under the leadership of our retired and beloved Dr. Martin. Roberta's only desire is to be saved. Everything else is secondary. After our children's praise team, the next voice you will hear will be our Ypsilanti girl, Roberta Perry. Thank you.
Hey! 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 Hey!
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning will mercies I sing. All I have needed thy hand have provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto thee. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
You are Lord.
Happy Sabbath. You know, I'm a little distraught. I don't know what I'm going to do when Willie leaves. I mean, who can I call to just play songs that they don't know? You know, who just do what I say when I say play this and they play this? Who can do that? Marcus, is that his name? Marcus, can you take Willie's place when he leaves? Do the best you can. Because when I'm down here, all of a sudden things just come to me, and I just want them to start playing stuff. They don't have to know it. If you're gifted by God, you should be able to do it, right? Happy Sabbath, everybody. I'm so grateful that you invited us back for the third year for your children's program. Grateful for your pastor. This is the first time he saw us. I hope he don't run us out. Pastor, hope we'll be okay. Anyway, I just want to thank everybody. Thank them for inviting us back out, and thank all the JMAC parents for coming out. JMAC students, please stand. I'll explain who they are a little later. Okay, and have a seat. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Last year, before I get started, let's have a word of prayer. Dear Father, please give us understanding and bless us this day. In Jesus' name, amen. Last year, children, who was here last year when we were here? Okay. The children, do you remember what we talked about? Say it. What is it? The arm of God. So, okay, now you got to have a test. I got to make sure that you remember everything that we talked about last year, because we can't go on to the next year if you've forgotten everything, right? All right. Now, how many pieces of armor are we talking about? 3, 4, or 6? Say it loud. Uh-huh. All right. Now, here we go. Little test. Name them. Name this piece of armor. Say it nice and loud. All right. I think I need you to, let me pass the mic since you're so smart.
Helmet of salvation.
All right. Helmet of salvation. Mm-hmm. All right. Another quiz. Number two. If Jesus has forgiven all of your sins, what do you wear?
Chestplate of righteousness.
Say it again.
Chestplate of righteousness.
Chestplate of righteousness. Who's your parents? Are they here? Okay, let's give it up for the parents. All right, number three. Here we go. Here we go now. Uh-huh. If you read the Bible every day, what are you carrying? Very good. Wonderful. I don't know if they're smart or I'm just a good teacher. Which is it? I think they're just smart. All right. Number four. Here we go again. Mm-hmm. So, if you carry the truth wherever you go, what are you carrying? What are you wearing?
The belt of truth.
All right. Love it. Love it. Love it. Uh-huh. Here we go. So, if you're protected, and we know we're protected every day by God's angels. What are you wearing?
The shield of faith.
Shield of faith, yes. You know, if I had some money, I think I'd give him something. But I don't have no money. All right, here we go. Last one. When you witness and tell people about the Lord, what are you wearing?
Boots of peace.
Shoes of peace. Gospel of peace. Wonderful. Give everybody a hand.
Mm-hmm.
See, I like to, when I'm here, are you a little chilly? Okay, so we're going to have to, I think it's because they don't have the heat on, but I don't know. But anyway, we're going to warm it up a little bit, okay? Here we go. So now, I always like to remind all parents and everybody in here, not just parents, that the greatest teachers in the world are who? Who's the greatest teachers in the world? God is the greatest teacher in the world. Who's next? Huh? You said parents are the greatest teachers in the world? You know, your clue really is what today is. Thank you. Children are the greatest teachers in the world. We learn from children every single day. Don't you learn something from your kids? Yes. One of the things that we learn from children laugh 300 times a day. Adults laugh only 20. We need to laugh more like children. If you can laugh at your problems, if you can laugh at stuff, it kind of makes it go away. So that's one thing we can learn. What? We need to laugh more, okay? Just little three things. Another things that children, we can learn from children, they forget and move on. Now, adults forget too. Once you apologize in sackcloth and ashes, once you told about 500 people on Facebook, then we're ready to forgive you. Some of us, okay, be like children. You can discipline them. You can spank them if those of you who still believe in that. And then the next day, they just love you more. We need to be just like children. And the last one, why they're so special, they ask questions, and they're not afraid whether it's a smart question or whether some people may think it's not so smart. Adults, they know they don't know it. They don't know it, but they won't ask because they don't want you to know that they don't know it. Children are smart, and we need to learn from children. So I want to bring up a group of children. They're from the Ypsilanti Church, and it's a group called JMAC. That stands for Jesus Makes Me a Champion Academy. And it's a program that's held every week at the Ipsy Church from children from not just Ipsy, from other churches as well. These children are learning what adults learn. They go through the amazing facts, they learn prophecy, but everything is done in their own language. So what it is that we want to bring out today is children can learn anything if you teach it to them in their own language. And children learn best when they see you doing it first. This don't do as I say, but do as, don't do it, wait a minute. This don't do as I do, but do as I say thing doesn't work for kids. They watch every single thing you do. So when you teach your children, make sure that you're doing it as well. So I want to bring up my JMAC students right now. Come on up. We have about 30 kids every week coming up to the front and make two rows for me. And the staff as well, if they would join them, that would be Tamika and Lynn. That would be Nikki. And my daughter thinks she's a staff member, but I'm going to let her come on up too. Come on up, Shauna. So this is JMAC, Jesus Makes Me a Champion Academy. So each Sabbath, they learn at least one memory verse for all of our fundamental beliefs, okay? They're learning the books of the Bible. Not only the books of the Bible, but what's in them. For instance, if I say Genesis, they'll tell you what's in them. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Deuteronomy, something like that. You know, because it doesn't make any sense for them to have a Bible and then they don't know how to find stuff, right? Not only that, they're learning their memory verses so that they can answer questions about what they believe. For instance, if they were walking down the street and somebody came up to you and said, "The Bible is not true," what would you say? Mm-hmm. Now, what if somebody said to you, "God created the devil bad"? What would you say? And what if somebody said, "God doesn't love me because I've done all these bad things"? What would you say? And what if someone told you that you don't have to keep the Ten Commandments anymore? What would you tell them? And the last one, these are just a few, but they're going to know all 28, okay? Last one. What if somebody says that the dead can come back? What would you say? Amen. Praise the Lord. So this is just a little small token that children can learn anything and they can memorize anything because their minds are sharp, a lot sharper than ours, okay? And then you'll know when we do the little program before why their minds are so short. If you notice, you may sit down, the adults didn't know the memory verses. Why? Okay, we're going to go ahead, and there's a theme song that goes with J-Mac that we sing every Sabbath, and we want to sing this theme song for you before they sit down. Come and join us. Oh, okay. Thank you. Chase Wilder is also the chaplain. He looks like he's older, but he's only 14 years old, and he's the chaplain of J-Mac. He doesn't have a t-shirt because he's growing too fast, and anybody got that kind of money to be buying a shirt every month because he keeps growing. So if we can play that song now, it's called "We're Children of the King," and we teach them every day, every Sabbath. Always say that you're a child of the King. A little louder. A little louder.
Okay.
parents, always remember, your children can learn everything that you learn. Teach them everything that you know. Make sure that you're doing it in their language, that you're using creativity if you got any. Okay, now we know that children are smart. They can learn everything as long as you teach them. Now I know that the children at City Temple, they know what's happening next week. Tell us all what's going on October 31. Well, say it loud. Okay, so now here's the thing. You're gonna learn something today. And when someone comes up to you and they're gonna say, why don't you go trick-or-treating? You're going to tell them why you don't go trick-or-treating. Because I know that no one in here trick-or-treats. How do I know that? Because you know better. And once we finish the story, then if you don't know why, you're certainly going to learn. So this lesson is for you to teach others why that Christians do not trick-or-treat. Are you ready? All right. I mean, really, are you ready? All right. Here we go. Okay. All right. Everything you say and everything you do, you must be like a private eye. You shouldn't do things just because it's fun. You must know the reason why. Just because something is exciting and you want to join the crowd, remember, everything you say and do must make Jesus proud. Children are asking, but it's Halloween. Tell us, what can we do? Well, this lesson will explain it all, and it'll be very clear to you. Some say it's okay to trick or treat. To them, it's fine and dandy. But boys and girls, I want you to know, Halloween is more than just candy. About 2,000 years ago is when Halloween arrived. People believed that on that day, the dead could come back alive. Can the dead come back alive? No. Did you know there are people who worship the devil every single hour? And they believe that on Halloween, the devil gives them extra power. And what about the words trick or treat? Do you even have a clue? It means if you don't give me some candy, I'm going to do something bad to you. People flock to costume shops, picking costumes to rent and buy. They dress as witches, angels, Disney characters, and they don't even know why. Do you know where costumes came from? Again, do you have a clue? Costumes are believed to trick evil spirits so that they won't bother you. And even if your costume is Iron Man or princess with golden hair, it doesn't change what Halloween stands for, no matter what you wear. Why did children go door to door? What does it mean to trick or treat? Well, people gave children candy to keep away evil spirits with sweets. Millions of jack-o'-lanterns light up the Halloween scene. Boys and girls, they would throw it away if they knew what this symbol means. Here's another Halloween symbol, more famous than the vampire bat. People believe that when someone dies, they came back as a black cat. Is that true? No. You're probably saying, but I don't believe these things. I'm just having a little fun. But when you know what Halloween stands for, it should make you turn and run. But can our church have a Halloween party without the Halloween symbols and charms? We could dress up as Bible characters. Surely that can't do any harm. So if you're asking this question, then Jesus will probably say, why would you want to even celebrate
the devil's holiday. Remember, Jesus is always watching you. And how do you think he feels when we join with others to celebrate a day that's against what is real? But what do I do with all this candy? Should I give it to the poor? Well, if you still have the receipt, just take it back to the store. So don't moan and groan, pout and shout, cry and huff and puff. Halloween is not for Christians. Celebrate Jesus, and that's enough. Jesus has nothing to do with Halloween. I pray this lesson is understood. No matter how we may try to change it, say it with me, we can't make evil good. Amen. And these are your Bible texts that you may want to look at. So, will I be seeing anybody from City Temple knocking on doors trick-or-treating next week? Huh? I want to hear a big no. Thank you. Hey, all right, thank you. Mm-hmm. So parents, as you teach your children, make sure you teach them these things. Teach them about what the holidays mean. They're smart enough to learn. Yes. Oh, thank you. Thank you. At this time, it is now time for not the children's story, but the parents' story. So we don't have enough room for all the parents to come down to the front. So parents, just remain in your seats. This story is just for you. Parents, are you listening? That was really weak. All right, here we go. For parents only. Once upon a time, there were three Christian parents who understood their sacred duty and calling. They understood that their child was a gift from God and only He could keep them from falling. They all received the same training supplies, Adventist home, child guidance, and the Bible. They read these books inside and out, but not all felt they were reliable. Mother number one began to train, but she was rigid and a fanatic. She was so afraid of making a mistake, she made her child's life traumatic. Every time her child did something wrong, she would hold up the Bible and yell, "Jesus don't like ugly, and you are doomed to hell." Her child obeyed, but it was out of fear, taught by harsh tones and scowling faces. She said, "If this is what Jesus is like, I'll find love in other places." Mother number two began to train, but she put her discipline on the shelf. She said, "I'll be my child's best friend and just let him express himself." Whatever the child felt like doing, the mother would never refute. He became the terror of the church. His mom said, "He's so cute." She gave him timeouts every now and then. She thought her discipline was ideal. The child grew up not living by principle, but according to how he feels. Mother number three began to train every divine instruction she kept. She was on her knees every single day while Jesus guided her step by step. Mom encouraged her child in everything. The child's happiness grew and grew. And whenever mom made mistakes, she said, "I'm sorry, my little boo." When her child was disappointed and sad, mom was gentle, firm, and calm. Her child saw an example of Jesus Christ through her forgiving and loving mom. So moms, if you happen to be like number one or number two, don't worry or let it get you down because you know what to do. Just simply tell Jesus you're sorry and start all over again. He's a God of forgiveness and he's your and your child's best friend. So which mom are you? You're number three? Praise God for number three moms. Amen. And now, the reason why your children are so smart and why they can learn, why they have excellent memories, is because they eat right. I hope. I pray. Boys and girls, raise your hand if you eat fruits and vegetables. And we can go ahead and have that, start that next one, Melissa. Raise your hand if you eat fruits and vegetables every day. How many know how much fruits and vegetables you should eat? How many servings? 5 to 9, say it. 5 to 9. And bring that up a little louder. So I'm going to tell you a story. It's about a young man, well, a boy named Junko. What's his name? Junko did not eat fruits and vegetables at all. What happened to him? His heart and brain got upset, decided to leave him, and they took him to court. So you're going to see this story about Junko, and I want you to take home and make sure, parents, because kids don't buy their own food, that you have plenty of fruits and vegetables for your children every single day. So you're learning a lot of different things today. So, but I want you to make sure that the foundation of everything you learn, you gotta be able to think right and have good minds. So sit back and relax and watch Junko, the junk food junkie.
Attention anyway, they just don't like us.
But this group is different, Veggie. Some boys and girls in the audience like us, don't you, boys and girls?
Yeah, they'll like us if we cover ourselves with icing and candy sprinkles. Well, yeah, they'll like us then.
No. I believe there's someone who likes us just as we are. Natural, simple, and beautiful.
And what makes you so sure, Fruity? Whatever. There, I took a bow. See you later. Bye.
Oh, but wait, Veggie. If you go, then who's going to tell our audience about the good things that are in vegetables?
You can tell them. We've been doing this forever. You should know the script by now.
Me? I can't tell them about vegetables. I'm a favorite. You're vegetables. They need to hear it from you.
All right. Whatever. I'll do the show. Just stop crying, you big baby.
I'm Veggie. We got news for you, so get ready.
If you want your heart to continue to pump,
you gotta stop eating all of that candy and junk.
Hello? Howdy. Excuse me.
We're trying to do a show here. Stop the music!
Oh, I'm so sorry, but I have a special delivery here for Fruity and Veggie. Are you Fruity and Veggie?
Yes, I'm Fruity.
And I'm Veggie. We got news for you, so get ready.
Hey, that's so funny. Everybody wants to be a star nowadays. But anyway, could you just sign here, please?
Hold up. We don't just sign anything unless we know what it is. Just read it to us.
Well, it's not proper protocol, but okay. Who cares? I'll just read it to you. All right, it says here, Dear Fruity and Veggie, you are summoned to appear in a puppet school.
Whoa, whoa, Yeah. Why? When? Where? How? My hair? I don't have an outfit. All right, oh, wait a minute.
Rhoday, let him finish reading. You are so spastic.
Well, let's see. It says here that Junko, alias Junk Food Junkie, is taking his heart and brain to court.
Hearty and deep, granola?
That is so deep.
Is he crazy?
Well, it seems, let's see here. It says, his heart and brain stopped working due to a lack of fruits and vegetables in his body. Yada, yada, yada. Just sign here, please.
And why do we have to appear in court?
It's obvious. We got to appear in court to prove that Junko's heart and brain stopped working because the big guy wasn't eating his fruits and vegetables.
That crazy kid. So when do we have to go?
Now.
Now?
Yeah, now!
Well, show's over, boys and girls. We gotta go to court. See ya. Eat your fruits and veggies.
No. Veggie, we can't just leave the boys and girls like that. What about the show? The show must go on!
Well, then the boys and girls can just come to court with us. Duh. Must I think of everything?
We can't take these kids to court with us. Are you crazy?
And why not? They probably watch court TV every single day.
Featuring real puppets and real cases. The Puppets Court draws on ordinary puppets who have filed grievances in civil court and have opted to have their cases heard by the one and only Judge Eatright. Junko, alias Junk Food Junkie, is suing his heart and brain because they are no longer working properly. He says, "All of a sudden, my heart and brain stopped working, and I have no idea why." Yeah, right. Anyway, he's suing for a new heart and a new brain. Hardy and Brinola, Junko's heart and brain, is countersuing. They state that they have been daily abused by all of the junk food that Junko has been eating, which has caused them to not work properly. They stated if he had eaten his fruits and vegetables, we would still be working today. This is a simple case of garbage in, garbage out.
All rise. The Honorable Judge Eatright presiding.
All right, this court is now in session. Please state your name for the record.
Yo, what's up, yo? My name is Junko, but most people call me Junko Junkie. What?
All right, thank you, Junko. Will you please state your names for the record, please?
I'm Hardy.
I'm Brinola.
We're his heart.
And Brin.
Great. Okay, we'll start with you, Junko. First, can you tell me, why do they call you Junk Food Junkie?
No, sure, Your Honor, but I guess it's because, you know, every now and then I might eat just a little bit of junk food, Your Honor. Just a little bit.
Every now and then? What? Come on, Junko. You eat junk food every day.
And that's right, Your Honor. And we had a proof, too,
every
that
now
he eats junk food every single day with no fruits and
that's
vegetables
right.
at all. And that's why they call him Junk Food Junkie. Tell the truth, Junko. Wait. Yo, hearsay, Your Honor. Hearsay, I tell you. I object,
okay,
Your Honor.
Okay, wait a minute. Order in the court. Okay, Junko, better known as Junk Food Junkie. I understand that you're suing your heart and brain because you stated that they stopped working for no reason. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's right, Your Honor. That's right.
No, that's not true. He filled his body with junk food, and now I have heart disease.
Okay.
That's why I stopped working properly.
That's right, Your Honor. And I couldn't give instructions because I couldn't think clearly. And now I feel a stroke coming on right now.
Oh, and I feel a heart attack coming.
Oh, goodness. So do I. Okay, listen, Hardy and Brainola, you get your turn to speak, okay? Continue, Junko.
Yeah, that's right. Yo, thank you, Your Honor. All right, now check this out. Yo, I have actual proof that I have in the past eaten fruits and vegetables.
Sure.
And no matter of fact, I have the dates written down right here. Well, they're not right here, but they're at home.
Of course.
But for real, that's beside the point. I've eaten fruits and vegetables twice this year. Now, check this out, Jack. Now, twice is better than nothing at all, right?
Wait a minute. Hold on. You got to be kidding me. Your Honor, everybody needs 4.5 cups of fruits and vegetables every single day. You know what to ask? Ask Fruity and Veggie.
Wait. And who might I ask is Fruity and Veggie?
You don't know Fruity and Veggie?
Obviously not.
And your name is Judge Eats Right.
Excuse me.
Fruity and Veggie are only the stay healthy entertainers. Mm-hmm. One of the greatest entertainers in the world that teach everybody why we should eat our fruits and vegetables.
And anybody who eats right will know about Fruity and Veggie.
That's right.
Excuse me. Are you saying that I, Judge Eat Right, don't eat right?
Oh, no, Your Honor. I'm not saying that.
I didn't think so.
It's just kind of strange that you never heard of Fruity and Veggie with a name like Judge Eat Right.
Oh, she in trouble, Yo-Yo. I think that's what she's trying to say, Yo-Yo.
Excuse me. Order in the court.
Yo, Judge Eat Right. If I was Judge Eat Right, I wouldn't take that if I was you.
Junko, if I get one more outbreak out of you, you'll be escorted out of my courtroom.
Yo, Wanda, put him in jail.
You know what? I'm putting you in jail. Bailiff, get him out of here. We'll take a 5-minute recess until Junko gets himself together.
Get your hands off me.
What did he eat today?
He ate a donut for breakfast, dipped in cinnamon glaze, a chocolate-covered Pop-Tart with a glass of lemonade. For lunch he had some French fries, swimming in melted cheese. Junko is a junkie who eats whatever he pleases. Who eats whatever he pleases. Who eats whatever he pleases.
The Puppets Court will continue with Garbage In, Garbage Out, Judge Eat Right presiding.
All rise.
All right, Fruity and Veggie, can you take the stand, please? All right, I understand that you have evidence to prove that Junko's heart and brain left him because he didn't eat fruits and vegetables. Is this correct?
Yes, that's about it.
Thank you. Can you please state your name for the record?
I'm a Fruity.
And I'm Veggie. We got news for you, so get ready.
Oh, no. Order in the court. Listen, since both of you are experts on the subjects of fruits and vegetables, can you please tell the court why fruits and vegetables are so important?
We love to.
Yeah, that's our job.
You're going to need a seat because we need some room.
We need some room.
Yeah. I'm Veggie. We got news for you, so get ready. If you want your heart to take it apart, you gotta stop eating all of that candy and junk.
Hardy and Brainola, will you please take the stand?
Yes, Your
And without
Honor.
A song, please.
Okay.
Now, if I'm correct, you're also countersuing Junko for a new body?
Yes, that's correct.
True indeed.
Okay, thank you. Okay, will you please state your case for the court?
I need to approach the bench.
Go ahead.
Your Honor, I'm his heart.
Well, obviously.
I'm a muscle. Mm-hmm. It doesn't take much to keep me working.
Okay.
I need fruits and vegetables so that I can do my job. Mm-hmm. I pump fiber to the cells. I pump minerals. I pump vitamins.
Okay.
And I get it from fruits and vegetables. Mm-hmm. And if he doesn't eat it, I can't pump it.
I understand. Okay, so yes. Fiber, vitamins, and minerals are in fruits and vegetables.
Yes.
Is that what you're saying?
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, well, that makes sense. That makes sense. Go on, please.
Thank you, Your Honor, because I'm on a roll.
I see.
Go ahead, auntie.
I provide energy and nutrients to keep the body alive.
Okay.
But I can't do my job if I'm sick. And I will not have, I repeat, will not have mm-hmm. the other organs looking at me funny mm-hmm. because I'm pumping bad blood.
Right.
Like it's my fault. Oh, no, mm-hmm. no. I will not have this. Something's got to change. Something has got
okay.
to change.
Okay, okay. Well, let me just make sure I'm clear here. If you don't eat fruits and vegetables, uh-huh. then your heart will pump bad blood to the
yes.
cells.
Mm-hmm.
And the blood is bad if it doesn't contain any fiber or nutrients or minerals or any of that good stuff.
Yes, you got it, Judge.
Okay.
And that's what causes heart disease.
Got it.
And
got
maybe
it.
Even a heart attack or a stroke even.
All right. Well, wow. I really didn't know all of this. Well, I really need to eat more fruits and vegetables myself,
oh,
huh?
Yes.
Okay. Well, Brainola, what do you have to say about it?
Well, is it okay if I approach the bench as well, Your Honor?
Please, go ahead.
Well, as you can plainly see, I am his brain, Your Honor.
Uh-huh.
I control everything. I tell the organs what to do. So, in other words, I run this. And I don't have any time to be making no mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, without the fruits and vegetables, I don't have the energy. I need to keep everything under control.
Okay, yes. Okay. Well, the brain, too, needs fruits and vegetables. Is that right?
Uh-huh. I need the fruits and vegetables to boost everyone's IQ.
Okay,
so that means
I didn't know
everyone
that.
Smart. I need fruits and vegetables to give everyone a good memory.
That's
I
right.
need fruits and vegetables so I can help people think clearer
mm.
and make good decisions. Now, can I get a witness here?
That's
you
right.
saw Junko's temper.
Boy,
junk food
I.
make you angry. It make you irritable. And
yes.
fruits and vegetables keep you under control. Johanna, everything you eat comes to me to bring. Case closed, man.
Okay, okay. Well, I say case closed, but I've heard enough, and I'll be back with my decision in a minute. Why don't you go sing a song or something?
Ooh, who will be to blame? Will Junk Food Junkie win, or his heart, or his brain? Junko is in trouble. I think he should confess that if he ate fruits and vegetables, he wouldn't be in this mess.
All right.
All right, I'm back. Let's bring out Junko, Hardy, and Brainola. Bailiff, has Junko got himself together yet?
He's better, Your Honor. We pumped him full of water.
Good, good. Now, Junko, what do you have to say to these charges?
Uh-huh.
Your Honor, I throw myself at the mercy of the court.
I'm not surprised.
I'm guilty. I'm guilty.
Uh-huh.
I'm guilty, Your Honor.
I knew it.
Yo, I lied. I never eat fruits and vegetables.
I knew
my
it.
Body's in a horrible mess because
mm-hmm.
I don't eat junk food.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't
mm-hmm.
understand about fruits and vegetables. No, please, Hardy. Please, Brainola.
Yes.
Please come back
indeed.
To me. I
oh,
promise to eat my
will,
fruits and vegetables
Junko.
So you can work
I
properly again.
Okay, okay. Get up off your knees. Well, it looks like things have worked out for all of you.
Hmm.
All right, here's my decision. My verdict is that you, Junko, will eat 5 to 9 servings of fruit and vegetables every day.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
All right, so your body will
yes.
be healthy and strong.
All
okay.
Right.
Now, case
mm-hmm.
dismissed.
All right. That's what
I'm
talking
so
about.
So wait a minute. Hold on, Joe. So what are you saying,
huh?
Judge? Is my brain in my heart? You're coming back to me or what? What are you saying?
I don't know. Talk to them about that. I don't make that decision. But like I said, case dismissed.
Oh, what do you think, Brainola? Should we go back to him?
Well, I don't know. He messed us up pretty bad, man. You know that stroke thing, you know.
Yes, but
I don't know.
Let's forgive him. Let's just go back to him.
Oh, come on, guys. Please, Hardy. Please, Brainola. Come on, please. Well, okay, but you got to promise to eat your 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every single day, Junko.
Yes.
You hear me, Junko? I'm not kidding now. I'm not kidding. Okay. I promise I'll eat my fruits and vegetables. Please come back to me, guys. Please.
Alrighty then. Make room, big guy, because we're coming back.
Mm-hmm.
he is a healthier boy. He started eating all his veggies and fruit. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, his heart pumps better. His brain is alert, cause they hang out in the same food group. Oh, 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 no more junk will he buy from the store. He said,
get out of here, I don't want you no more.
Fruits and veggies are all he can say. He eats 5 to 9 servings a day.
What?
He eats 5 to 9 servings a day.
Hey, 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 hey,
hey. Let me see your hands if you're like Junko. Tell the truth, now tell the truth. Let me see your hands if you're eating your fruits and veggies every day. 5 to 9, wonderful, wonderful. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. So you see, the foundation of everything of the Jesus Christ is that we make sure that we're able to think and make good decisions so we can continue to be smart, so we can teach our children, so they can continue to be smart, all of that good stuff. Are you with me? And you know, when you teach your children about anything, just make sure that you understand their type of language. So, I want to give praises to God because finally I was able to publish my first book. And it's entitled, Jesus Loves to Hear Me Pray. And it's how Jesus feels when children are praying. In this book, you can find it on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Outskirts Press. But because you're my City Temple friends and I love you with an everlasting love, I know you're going to say I'm getting ready to give it to you, but I'm not. I'm going to invite you to my book signing. But you'll get an invitation. And I just thank you so much for listening. I thank you so much for bringing your children out. I just thank the JMAC parents for coming out and bringing their children. I thank the pastor for allowing me to come into his church with all this paraphernalia. Thank you for all of that. But I pray that you did get the message. And Willie, wherever you go, when I come back, I need you to come on back and play some stuff for me. The church will pay for him to come back, right? Right? They'll put you up and feed you and everything. So we just want to give God the praise this morning. And we just thank you, Jesus, for everything. Let's bow our heads. Thank you, Lord, for everything that you do for us every day. Thank you for teaching us how to take care of our bodies. Thank you for your word that makes us powerful and makes us strong. Help us to be better Christians for you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good afternoon. I really hope everyone has truly enjoyed today's program. You have wonderful. Thank you. Can we have another round of applause and a hearty amen for all the participants? Elder Perry, thank you so much for coming back and bringing your team with you. We truly enjoyed today's message as always. You did a wonderful job. It's important to acknowledge our children's ministry team. I'm going to ask the committee members to please stand, those that are here. Some of our members had other commitments that they had to attend to, but Sharita, Marquita, Shannon, Leisha, Ania, Andrea, Ms. Brown, Tanya, Elder King, please stand. Thank you so much. It's been a long 3 years that have come to an end. We certainly appreciate you holding on with us as we move forward. We also like to give a special thank you to our very dedicated, hardworking behind the scene support system. That would include Mary Skinner, Elder Juanita Martin, Sandia Henry, Melissa Martin, Lindsay and Barbara Bryant, Mr. and Mrs. Bertram. Thank you so much for all of your help, as well as the Vacation Bible School team. We thank you as well for your help.
And also for Mr. Solomons, who I call often, and he always reminds me, Erica, you know I'm not on the AV team, but for some reason, my music and my videos are always downloaded when I need them. Thank you so much, Mr. Solomon.
Yes, thank you very much. We also like to thank our pastor, Pastor Thomas. Thank you so much for your leadership and direction and allowing us to take over today's program. Thank you.
And Mrs. Perry. Words escape me, but for the last 3 years, we have called on you and you have delivered. Mrs. Perry did a retirement party, and she summed up this person's retirement in a nice, creative rap. And that's when the light went on, ding, 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 she's the one. And you have blessed us for these last 3 years, and we just want to take some time out to acknowledge you at this time. Come on up.
It's, I'll hold up so everybody can see it. It says Roberta Perry, Children's Ministry, City Temple, 2016, but it should say 2014, 2015, 2016. Thank you so much for all of your service and hard work. We truly appreciate you.
Since this is Children's Day, we also have a special gift for our children. So after benediction, we would like for all of our children who are here sitting, especially our guests, and if there are any more in the audience who are not seated in front, if you would come down after the benediction and sit right here, and we will pass out to you, if you remain seated, children under 12, of course, a special gift. So please remain seated after the benediction, and the children's ministry team will present you with a special gift. Thank you. Happy Sabbath.
Okay. Sharita, can you come back up, please? I think we ought to acknowledge these that have taken a lead role in creating, facilitating, and developing this program today. Let's put our hands together. Thank you. Thank you. Before you take your seats, I want to share this with you. When I had my first meeting with Erica, I don't know if you dial back to that, okay? I challenged her and I said, now let me tell you what I really like to see. Now, this is going to be a tall order, really tall order, and I'd really like to see this going forward. But I have to admit, Elder Perry, what you did today was phenomenal. How many of you are just excited and proud about what they're doing at the Ypsilanti Church? Isn't that awesome? Awesome. Awesome. Well, this is how it ties into our Erica Rudolph. When I sat with Erica, I said, you know, let me tell you what I envision, because the future of a church is through the children. And I said, I'd really like to see children's programs where you take the Sabbath services at least once every couple of months. So that's six different events within the course of a year. And this is what I'd envision, where the children would actually be given the opportunity to showcase what they can do. We train our children. We invest in our children. And I want to share with all of our parents who have small children that no matter what other churches can offer, we can offer that too. We have to invest in that, and we have to work together. And let me tell you one of the things that I see that's missing here in Lake Region Conference, and I want to stretch out a little bit here, okay? We don't bring our churches together for all of the different gifts and skills. We're competing with one another, but we should not be. We're all on the same, what's the word I'm going to say? Team. That's right. We're all on the same what? Team. And so I want you to know, as pastor of this church, you have an open door. We'd love to see you come back, Elder Perry, and hold some training here at City Temple, not only for our leadership team in children's ministries, but all other churches, because God has given you a gift. Would you all agree with that? I mean, this is a gift. We went through three different elements for the children today. All of them were engaging. All of them were effective. All of them are life-changing. And some of the things that you were actually talking about have been preached about in the pulpit, but they're not meant for the children in the same way. We have to have programs specifically designed to capture the energy and the interest of little people. Okay, the little people, that's what I called my children when they were small. I called them the little people. So I want to encourage this team, this leadership team, to go to your prayer closet and ask the Lord, going forward, how can we grow the gifts that God has given us here by networking with the Ypsilanti Church? You are doing some unique things there. Would you agree with that? But we can do it in all of our churches if we put forth the commitment, the financial support, because it's going to take money. Am I correct? All right. And as well as determination to work. Everybody say work. Yeah, this doesn't come because the pastor gets up in the pulpit and say, let's all go do this. This comes because you're dedicated to this. The other people who are working with you are dedicated to this. So, to me, that was the best way to end the service today. We acknowledge what you've done, and I know that we have been inspired. We've been challenged. Our children have loved it, and I pray that as we go forward, we will do more collaboration, that we can grow all of our children, because it didn't say the Ypsilanti children or the City Temple children. The Bible says that all of my children shall be what? Taught of the Lord. If you believe that, say amen. Thank you, ladies. Thank you so much for what you've done. So I guess you know that I endorse what you did. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's all stand. Do we have a closing hymn from the praise team? You may be seated. I'm sorry. Okay. That was an exercise move. Okay. All right. The praise team is going to come up. They're going to sing. And I'm going to ask if our children's ministry leader would actually give us our closing prayer. Would you do that for us? I'm sure you will. All right.
Over, and we are going home.
would like to make one brief announcement that next Sabbath here at City Temple is Youth Federation. So please remember that, and we'll see you next Sabbath. Will you please bow your heads and close your eyes for closing prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, you have blessed us this morning with your presence. You have come to worship with us, and you have given the children a voice that they can show their gratitude to you. We thank you for Mrs. Roberta Perry, for her dedication, her time, and her effort. And we ask that your presence remain with her in her ministry as she teaches the children of your word. We thank you for this Sabbath day, and we'll see you next week. And we do pray. Amen.